Hi, I'm Amanda Sardinas.
And I'm Kayla Mendez. Today is April 26, 2019.
Welcome back to Braddock TV. In the past century, women have been receiving an exceptional amount of recognition for their work in scientific discoveries.
Here's Vanessa with this week's spotlight.
Hey Bulldogs, black holes have always been an interesting topic in our society. We have seen many recreations of them in movies, but we have never had an actual picture of one until now. On April 10th, 2019, the first picture of a black hole ever taken was released. Katie Bowman is a researcher who played a crucial part in capturing this picture. Yet because of her gender, her work on this project has been questioned. Recently, this issue has been getting a lot of attention and surfaces many questions on gender inequality in the science industry.
I believe that ending gender inequality in the science area has to start with elementary school teachers and middle school teachers and high school teachers. We need to emphasize that women can learn math and can be very good at math and science, and we need to give them the opportunities. Many times, again, it's believed that girls cannot handle higher level math, and that is a disservice to women and a disservice to the field, because there's a lot of intelligent women who would be doing amazing things if given the opportunity and the belief, not only by themselves but their parents and society and their teachers.
I think that the media backlash that Kitty has been receiving is outrageous. It's 2019 and these issues of gender inequality should be way past us. It's unfair that women aren't being empowered the way that they're supposed to be.
The backlash Katie Bowman has received over the black hole picture and all the issues that have developed with women in science show that gender equality in our country has a long way to go.
Our Braddock Bulldogs have been very busy with tons of events reigning over them.
Here's Andrea with this week's recap.
The senior class went to Grad Bash on April 5th. Where they got the opportunity to have the thrilling night at Universal and Islands of Adventure. The seniors also enjoyed a concert featuring a special guest, DJ Nasty. On April 4th to the 7th, the Key Club won third place in the Platinum Division for Most Developed Club in all of Florida and the Caribbean Islands. The club's growth increased by 151% from the previous year to this year.
In the Platinum Division, in third place with 151% increase, G. Holmes Braddock Senior High School.
Endometriosis Month takes place in March, but Braddock HOSA hosted a walk on April 6th to bring awareness to the painful disorder, where tissue grows outside the uterus. Silver Knights nominees prepared and had their interview on Wednesday, April 10th for their selective award. On April 13th, the Superintendent Alberto Carvajal teamed up to host the 4th Annual Race for Education 5K Challenge. The walk benefited local public schools and donated a percentage of race proceeds to participating schools in which several of Braddock's clubs took part in. GEMS Dance Team participated in the Anti-Bullying Awareness Hip Hop Dance Competition among Miami-Dade and Broward County schools on April 13th. They won first place within Miami-Dade schools and won grand champions of the entire competition. Congratulations, ladies, and keep up the great work.
First place winners for Dade County is
The scholarship brunch took place in the morning on April 24th, where students were invited to dress formally in order to be recognized for their achievements.
For the past couple of weeks, our Braddock athletes have put up their most stellar performances.
From track and field to flag football, our players have been cramped with endless practice and tough competition.
Here's Ellie with this week's sports.
On April 27th, the track team traveled to Southridge for districts. Eight of the team members, Paula Ben-Cosme, Jordan Ford, Lisa Ajuadi, Allison Estorga, Leah Rosado, Pedro Garcia, Joey Stallings, and Ethan Bitter went on to regionals. Great job to the track team for their amazing scores.
Recent events have risen and caused news buzzing all over the world.
Here's Eileen with World News.
On April 15, 2019, the famous cathedral Notre Dame de Paris caught on fire shortly after 6:50 p.m. The fire lasted over 15 hours, with many firefighters constantly dousing the 856-year-old cathedral in water. The cause of the fire is still unsure, however, authorities say that it was most likely an electrical fire. Since the fire had been put out, over $1 billion have been donated to the rebuilding of the church by many billionaires. On Easter Sunday, a series of bombings took place in Sri Lanka, targeting many Christian churches. The terrorist group ISIS has since taken responsibility for these attacks, claiming it was in retaliation of the mosque attacks in New Zealand a few weeks back. The death toll has increased to 300. According to many news outlets, the Sri Lankan security force were warned almost 10 days prior about the terrorist group attack plans, but no action was taken.
Worried about impeachment, Mr. President?
The special counsel investigation, or otherwise known as the Mueller investigation, came to an end on March 22nd with the actual 400-page report coming out on April 18, 2019. Mueller conducted this investigation to try to prove that the Russians were involved in the 2016 presidential campaign. The report proved to have almost no evidence to impeach Trump. However, it is said that these findings do not mean that Trump will never be impeached.
Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at @GHB_TV.
And tune in to our YouTube channel on Fridays at 10:15 for new episodes.
And remember to make it happen with Braddock TV.
Do you know Vans always land right side up?